What's good, y'all? Master Sud here. To go read episode live reactions in the description below. I'm blurry as hell right now. Hopefully the focus will come back. There it is. And this is my thoughts on the episode. I kind of can't keep calling reviews because I don't see them for that. But here's the thing about this episode, right? As you guys can see, now, I have to say this every time. I did read the manga to this. But there's definitely a lot of points I don't exactly remember how they played out. This episode definitely proved that, to be real. But I know the big points of it. I have to admit that. But anyways, whatever. As you can see, there's a lot of fuckery going on. You know? First of all, you know, you see the thing with Yurei's ass. He's supposed to get Toru the hell up out of there. Instead, he's going to take detours and shit, putting Toru in much more danger than he need be. And when Juzo show up, he's going to lie to Juzo. First of all, lying to Juzo makes you a bitch. Second of all, he's like, we ain't calling nobody. My transmitter don't work. They ain't calling nobody. They ain't calling no fucking nobody. Really? Also, man. Washu. At the end of the day, Yurei got played. You mad but not mad about it. You expected Yurei to fuck it up in the first place, but you gave him the opportunity to fuck it all up. It's like, what was that, a wake-up call? Like, I'm going to give you this opportunity. I know you're going to fuck it up. When you going to fuck this up, you got to die or learn a lesson, bitch. Really, Washu? That's what Takazawa was out there like when Washu was talking to Kaneki. Well, excuse me, Sasaki. He's like, hey, I know that motherfucker in your ear. You know he's going to get you fucked up, right? Like, you know you're about to die, right? Don't blame me for what happens to your ass. He told your squad to leave. Don't blame me for this ass whooping. Wow. And Takazawa was also on that bullshit. What kind of shit is that? Like, when Takazawa stabbed that girl in that bathroom, sitting here talking about some. Now listen to my dad. Like, wait a minute. I'm thinking about killing y'all. Actually eating y'all. And you're going to bring up some bullshit from my past life, bitch? Man. It sucks because people like Sasaki and Juzo just over here trying to do right. They didn't try to take everybody out. They didn't even worry about the credit and none of that shit. They just trying to make sure their team get out of here. Make sure everybody get out of here. The objective is to take out Nuts. Take out, Big Mama, Madame, depending on what version you watch, and stop a good retreat. They already stopped the auction. That's basically it. All the other shit was Sue's servant, dude. You know, that guy. I mean, that's just extra. Low key. But it's a goal to take his ass out. Not to mention, they went afterwards, so that's another reason to take their ass out. But, anyways, man. The whole thing with Yurei losing like that, I mean, I don't want to just sum that up as there's always somebody better, but it's that thing where Yurei got set up so you don't want to just be like, damn, that's what happens to your ass, but you fucked up. That's what happens to your ass. While she's just in the car sitting there. I hope that car can blow my fuck up. Anyways, as long as it didn't go to Naki, I just don't got no sympathy for that fucker. I didn't have no sympathy for him in Rude A, so it's just like that. He's living in the present now since his current home is dead. I had nothing nice to say about that. Oh, you know. Sorry, Naki. We all seen the preview, so you've seen people showing up in the preview. In case you didn't see the preview, I ain't gonna say nothing. But yeah, man, as you can see, this is getting more and more, we're moving more and more into the shit right now. And basically, all we got left is the bosses, really. Like, besides the part with Akira going through the rest of the Gurry Tree people, which is going to come to a head eventually, we got Takizawa versus Sasaki. Yeah. Big Mama's hit the scene. About to eat Yurei's ass. Check. Nuts is now the S-rated ghoul. About to send the other troops after her. There you go. And Eto's just over there watching all this. So you know Eto's going to get into it eventually. You know she's just going to hop in eventually. So we haven't even reached the climax yet. So, there you go. The ride, this roller coaster, continues. Nuts just had to step on some nuts. That's just over there walking around. Not that damn sexy body of yours. And that girl fine as hell. Oh shit, it's nuts. Cuff him. Man. Everybody keeps talking about the whole thing with Sasaki. You know, he's half gold and shit. That basically what got Toru running around like goddamn crazy. But over here, like, it's just. Talking about I got one taste of that, like. That shit good. Shout out to Shampoo. Anyways, man, I'm gonna go ahead and get out of here. Another good ass episode of Tokyo Ghoul. I ain't gonna lie. I mean, earlier I was like, this series is surprisingly doing much better than I thought it would be, but there's some parts here and there. I'll admit some parts here and there, but very close to the source material so far. So Tokyo Ghoul Remanga's on the chance. So Tokyo Ghoul Remanga anime is doing its job as of right now. I hear they're going to be separating this into two parts, so there's a chance for them to fuck it all up like they did the first time. But hey, in my prediction, the next 7 episodes are going to be off the chain, so let's keep rolling. You watch this video, leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. Like this video for me. I'll see y'all. Peace out. Like I said, my live reaction's in the description below. This has been that good shit. I'm looking for a new outro. Shut up.